when you got a great product, really innovative product, and then people just start building something similar or even just copy you. So what do? You innovate the hell out of it and release something that people have to follow again. They just have to catch up. The other focus is not catching up. Yeah, this is a role. Video mic, wireless go to. Look at that, same form factor. I like that a lot. And with this same form factor, this is a receiver. And then the transmitter, the one, the two, shit. I'm sure it's fine. With this same form factor, they put in more features into the same body and even perform better. That's brilliant. But then when I say innovate the hell out of it for other people to catch up, actually other people had already catch up then and they released something that the original ROG doesn't have, is that they support two mics. This ROG Wireless GO only support one mic. So this time they have support two mics and then some. There are actually two more features that nobody has. That is what makes other people have to catch up with ROG mic. Let's get to it. But before that, you have to connect to your computer, use the new software to... you have to update the firmware update first. And then now you got some new feature. For example, the gain, you got 3 steps before, but now you got 10 steps. After you activate it, then you can set up the gain on the receiver itself. What's more, you finally got safety channel, and both transmitter can double as a recorder. Now the first really great feature is the safety channel. ROG has add in safety channel to the ROG Video Mic Pro Plus, which is a few 3 years ago, something like that. And then of course the new ROG Video and Video Mic NTG also got this feature, the safety channel feature. It's not focusing again. Come on, yeah, this one. Safety channel. What is the safety channel? Is that when it records sound, it will record the right channel louder than the left channel. So when you're in the editing, when you're recording and suddenly there's a loud sound and then or you set your volume wrong, suddenly the right channel clip is too loud, just clip. You just can't fix it in post-production. So then you have the left channel, which is quieter and properly not clipped. What is split? That's two mode. When you're using two mic, that's two mode, split and merge. When you use merge, the two mic, the sound of two mic will merge together and then output to your camera. The two sound is merged together. You can't separate it in post-production. If you use split, the two sound is separated. So the one mic will be on left channel, another mic will be on the right channel. So in post-production, you can separately adjust the volume or you can just mute one of them as you want. Now the safety channel, it will use up all the left and right channel on the receiver. So you can't use it when it's split, but you can use it when merged. When two mic is merged together, then with the safety channel, the right channel will be louder than the left channel. Or most of the time I shoot video by myself, it's just me. So I can just leave one at home and then set the receiver to merge. And now when I use this, this one voice of me will have safety channel, the louder on the right and quieter on the left. So this is so good when I used it by my own, just one mic. Safety channel is just so useful. Before I continue with the new feature, let's go down to the street and test out the range. Now this is the original Wireless GO, the first version, original. Yeah, let's see. I'll put it here. And the receiver will be just on top of the camera, just as usually you would do. So let me first test to face away from the camera, because if facing away, it usually receives less good, mean worse. Yeah. Testing. Actually really useful Oh, it's cutting out. Whenever I turn facing the camera, it immediately improves. So now this turn, it kind of like maybe come back a little bit. And then now, even if I'm facing away, so this is the actual useful distance of the original wireless goal, which because you don't want to be here, and then sometimes it cut out, now you don't, so I can walk away a little bit. Oh, it's cut out, yeah. So yeah, you don't want to be further away from this. So this is kind of useful for most situations, but not all. Obviously, if you're shooting wedding, you would definitely want a longer distance than this. So now this is a world wireless goal too. Not sure does it focus on it. Let's do the same test. That was the useful distance before, and now I turn around. It's all good. It's good. Oh, yes. Yes, this is cutting out. Yeah, so this is an improved distance. Actually, kind of double, I think. It's not really scientific because it will be different in different environments as well. If you're in a more dense population area than here, it will be worse. But yeah, this is a useful distance for this wireless goal too. So when I turn around, it still connects. Yeah. Now let's try how far I can go facing the camera, which I'm going to walk backward. So this is line of sight, they claim 200 meters of distance. Actually, this works pretty well because there are people in between me and the receiver, and it's still working. Wow, that's quite a lot. If I'm facing it, so this is still working. So yeah, okay, confirm. This is the distance that you can, I mean, it's actually, if you're facing the camera, if you are not turning around, but it's actually pretty good when even people in between, it still works. Yeah, okay. By the way, with Storyblog, just one subscription, you can get all their video, audio, photos, effect, all of them with just one affordable subscription. This is really what makes Storyblog great. You don't have to get different subscriptions on different sites. One affordable subscription and you get all of them. This is really just simple as that. So check it out with the link in the subscription down below. Whoa, look at this place. Wow, now I'm not talking about this place. I'm talking about the mic. I'm trying to compare the using a lavalier mic compared to the internal mic of the built-in mic of the wireless goal 2 transmitter. I am using lavalier mic. This is how I use my wireless goal before 100% of the time. But yeah, now it's a lavalier mic. But now I'm going to unplug it. Wait for it. Yeah, this is unplugged. Now is the built-in mic of the wireless goal 2 transmitter, which I think isn't bad at all. It's a little bit not as good, but not bad. And also, there's a little bit of ambient noise here, a bit of wind as well. I didn't bring the wind block, so you can see hear the difference. And also, this is a built-in mic of the old wireless goal as well, so you can hear the difference between the new and the old wireless goal. But the killer feature is built-in recording. Both of the transmitter is now a recorder as well. It is built-in, the memory is built-in, you don't have to plug in SD card. And whenever, you don't have to start recording. Whenever you turn it on and connect to the receiver, it will just start recording. And this is just as a really great backup. For example, if to prevent when the signal lost or just anything happened, if you plug this to a recorder and then you forgot to turn on the recorder, you still have the backup recording on both of these. The thing is you can't set the volume on both the recorder, you just have to depend on it. But then it is just a backup. So backup audio is actually really useful. I keep thinking I would make a video about why do you need backup audio. And I've also bought this. I'm actually using this as a backup audio. Whenever possible, I would actually have this turned on, now it's recording. And I just put it here, just basically here, just as a backup recording. I mean, the sound won't be perfect. It will get echo because it's a little bit further away from me compared to this mic. But then it's a great backup. If anything happened to this, anything interference, whatever, I still have something useful. Also, as a backup audio, if your main audio is fine, you don't have to even unload this file. Well, maybe you should, but for me, if the main audio is fine, I will just format the card and then just format it. You don't have to worry about, there's a lot of files I have to manage. Same with this, and you have two quality settings. You can have compress, which works for over 43 hours. Yeah. Or if you set it to uncompress, it will still work for 7 hours. And you don't have to worry about, you don't have to format whatever. If your main audio is fine, you don't have to worry about that. When it's full, it will just start to delete old recording and start new recording. It is only when you need the backup, you can just plug into your computer and export those backup. Well, let's go to, this is so great, but there's something that's less great. The thing is some features, especially the best feature, the safety channel and the recording, you have to connect it to your computer to activate it. There's no other way. And the second thing is not a bad thing, but the second thing you have to consider is that, yeah, there's dual channel that you can separate to left channel and the right channel, but then you can't set the volume gain separately on here. So there's something you have to consider. There's some other brand that you can set separate volume on the device itself, but usually they are bigger. And the last thing is the same as the Rode Wireless Go before, is that they all use built-in rechargeable battery, and rechargeable battery will die one day, and because it's built-in, it's not user replaceable. You have to send it back to Rode to have them replaced. Rode usually really good at replacing battery, doing repair for you. They don't charge you a lot. But then, honestly, most people will just throw this away and get a new one. This is wasteful because when the mic itself is working 100% perfectly, it's just the battery die, and then a lot of people would just throw it away. This is quite wasteful. So that's the thing, that's the dilemma of rechargeable battery. They are great, they are convenient, they make the device small, but then when they die. But that's it, guys. Thank you for watching. This is a really good choice. If you don't need this, you can still get the Rode Wireless Go. This is still really good. This is still give you a lot of peace of mind compared to other brands, because these are trusted and tested by a lot of people.